Welcome back to the Simply Maker channel. In today's video, I'll show you how to use Tuya Cloudcutter to flash this Wi-Fi power strip with ESPHome firmware and customize it for use with Home Assistant. Its design stands out from other Tuya-based power strips, featuring more premium materials and a fire-resistant shell. It's rated at 2,500 watt 10 amp. Maximum voltage is 250 volt. It included multiple safety features, like internal temperature detection and overload protection. Each outlet can be controlled individually via software control and includes a USB quick charge and a 30 watts PD port. This one is an international standard plug version, but it's also available in UK and EU standard plug. Let's start by flashing new firmware to the power strip using Tuya Cloudcutter. I have included a quick guide to installing Tuya Cloudcutter on a budget-friendly Raspberry Pi Zero in my previous video. If you haven't installed Tuya Cloudcutter yet, be sure to check it out via the link above. Before beginning the flashing process, it's essential to gather your device information in order to select the correct firmware to flash. There are a few ways to do this without opening up your device. You can search the Tuya Cloudcutter device profile database to see if someone has already included your device. Although Tuya Cloudcutter offers an extensive list of device profiles, finding an exact match can still be challenging. So my preferred method is using the Tuya app. Add your new device to the Smart Life app as you normally would. Go to the Device Settings page and scroll down to Device Update. In my case, the firmware version is 1.1.8. Now we can begin to flash the firmware by logging into the Raspberry Pi via SSH. Navigate to the Tuya Cloudcutter directory. Start Tuya Cloudcutter with the following command. Tuya Cloudcutter will start preparing the flashing process by building a Docker image. This may take a while the first time, so I recommend using a high-quality micro SD card to speed up the process. After the process is complete, choose option 2 to flash third-party firmware. Select by firmware version and name. Scroll down until you locate your device's firmware version. You may find multiple listings with the same firmware number, so select the one whose name closely matches your device's. Select ESPHome Kickstart firmware. Now Tuya Cloudcutter will start scanning for Smart Life access point. It's time to put your device in access point mode. If you're unsure how to do this, please refer to your device's manual for instructions. For the LDNIO power strip, we need to press and hold the power button for 5 to 8 seconds, then release. The LED will blink rapidly, indicating that the device is in pairing mode. Then press and hold the button again for another 5 to 8 seconds and release. Now the LED will blink slowly. If everything goes smoothly, Tuya Cloudcutter will connect to your device's access point and begin the initial setup. If not, you may need to repeat the process and select a different firmware name with the same device firmware version. You can stop the process by pressing Command and period. Once the initial setup is complete, you'll be instructed to power cycle your device and put your device back to access point mode. To power cycle your device, disconnect it from the main power, wait for a few seconds, and then reconnect it. Wait a moment for your device to start, then put your device back into access point mode using the earlier process. Now, wait for the flashing process to complete. Tuya Cloudcutter will close and return you to the command shell. You can now shut down the Raspberry Pi and close the terminal. Before continuing to the next step, I recommend power cycling your device once more. Use your computer or mobile phone to connect to the device's access point. Its name typically starts with Kickstart. Once connected, it should redirect you to the Wi-Fi network setup page. If not, open your web browser and navigate to 192.168.4.1. Select your local Wi-Fi access point from the list, enter the password, and then click Save. Wait a moment for it to connect to your local network. After it boot up and reconnect, find the new device IP address using your router settings page. If your new device not show up in the list, you may need to power cycle your device again. Open Itchiptool and navigate to UPK2 ESPHome tab. Click on Grab from ESPHome Kickstart. Enter your device's IP address. Now the Itchiptool will be reading your device's configurations and will switch to Options page. From here, you can select options to include in the YAML file. Once everything is set, click Generate. This will create a suggested YAML configuration, which you can copy and paste into ESPHome to use as a starting point. Once the update is complete, your new device should be discovered in Home Assistant. If not, you can also add it manually in the Devices and Services section. Go to ESPHome Integration. Click Add Device. Enter your device IP address. Now, you can go to the device's dashboard and test the power strip functions by pressing its physical button and controlling it from the dashboard. The default configuration should be working as expected. You can press the button on the power strip to toggle all sockets, and each socket can be controlled individually via the Home Assistant dashboard. With the default configuration, you might notice that the status LED stays red, regardless of whether the outlet is turned on or off, which doesn't reflect the outlet status. Additionally, if any of the relays are in a different state, because it is turned on or off individually through Home Assistant, by pressing the physical button, we'll toggle all relays simultaneously. This can lead to mixed states where some sockets turn on while others turn off, which isn't the intended behavior. This can be easily fixed by modifying ESPHome components and implementing a few custom scripts. I've included a link to written instructions, which contain all the command line and YAML code, so you can easily copy and paste them into your configuration. Let's start by modifying the LED behavior. The default configuration from Itchiptool uses a status LED component that only indicates the device's status. The LED will blink during startup to indicate that the device is connecting to the server, and it will stay off once the connection is established. To control the LED light while retaining the status LED behavior, I'll replace the status LED component with a status LED light component. I've set the light component's internal attribute to true to prevent it from being accidentally switched in Home Assistant. To display its status on the dashboard, you'll need an additional template binary sensor and link it to the light component. Next, I'll add scripts to control LED and relay behavior. The first script will monitor the state of each relay and control the status LED accordingly, and it also fixes the mixed state behavior caused by switch.toggle action used in the original YAML. The status LED will only turn off when all relays are off. If any relay is on, the LED will indicate its status by turning on. The second and third scripts will be added to each relay's on turn on and on turn off events to control the LED status. These scripts also prevent the main script from executing multiple times when the binary switch all is toggled. Add on turn on and on turn off actions to all relay switches. Replace the binary switch all with a new code. I've also added a long press action in the script. So, when you press and hold the button on the power strip for 3 seconds, it will force all switches to turn on. Finally, add a template button to button section. This button functions just like the physical button on the power strip, but it allows you to control it from the Home Assistant dashboard. Once everything is set, click Save and install it to your device. Even though this can also be done with Home Assistant automation, but by including it in the device firmware, ensures it will function even when the device is offline. Okay, that's it for installing and customizing ESPHome firmware. With Tuya Cloudcutter and ESPHome, you're not just limited to the functionality provided out of the box. You have the freedom to shape your smart home device according to your preferences. So, play around, and make your devices work just the way you want them to. Please note that not all Tuya devices can be flashed with Tuya Cloudcutter. Only the ones equipped with a supported chip are compatible, and sometimes manufacturers just switch to a different chip inside their product, while keeping the same shell and model name. I hope this video is helpful. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more exciting DIY ideas and projects. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments below. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching.